Kanye listened to the sound of crackling firewood and stared at the black object on her plate. She'd been pushing around the wooden disc for a good 10 minutes, ignoring the bemused stare of her grandmother. Finally, she summoned her courage and gave the object a brief sniff. Sharp, bitter scent flew up her nostrils, made its home there, causing her face to twist with disgust. Grandma, I can't believe you want me to eat a bug. Old woman threw some more wood under the cooking pot and snorted. It's not a bug, you fool girl, it's a berry. Why the heck would you be feeding you bugs? Well, it sure looks like a bug, said Kanye. I think it's burnt or something, because it smells terrible. With that, Kanye held her nose and threw the berry in her mouth, chewing as little as possible. Oh yeah, that's terrible, all right. Why, you little brat, laughed the old woman. Look at the sass on you. You've been spending too much time with me, and that's a fact. 5 years had passed since the moment when Kanye's grandmother saved her from the bullies. It's often the way with two stubborn people. Their relationship had grown in fits and starts, but moved forward all the same. Meals that used to be somber affairs were now filled with laughter and hurled abuse in equal measure. Kanye could not remember a time when she had been happier. As years went on, Kanye started to shoulder more and more of the daily responsibilities. Her grandmother's legs grew weaker by the day, and she could no longer do many of the chores she was used to take for granted. And so this morning found Kanye lacing up her work boots with the breakfast of burnt berry rolling through her belly. Where are you going today? Asked Grandma suddenly. Kanye looked up surprised. The old woman really asked for specifics anymore. Well, I was going to check out the Kelma trees and see if they were ripe. I thought we could make some jam or something. Oh, and I'm going to pick up some flagstones, so I need to take the wheelbarrow. Flagstones? What in the heck for? Kanye stared at her grandmother, then held out her arm and swept her around her home. Constructed mostly of cloth, rope, and rubble, the old place sagged like a boxer in the final round. Grandma, a dying cat could chew through this house. I'm going to build stone walls so we have some protection. The woman laughed, exposing her toothless grin to the world. Girl, if a bunch of thieves were to ransack this old place, let them come. We got nothing worth stealing anyway. Don't worry about thieves, I'm worried about shades. People saw one west of the village yesterday. The woman tilted her head and stared at her granddaughter. Well, shoot, I don't know why you have to do it today. Can be worry about it some other. Grandma, no. If I don't go to the Kelma trees, we won't eat tonight. You know that. Confused expression paced across the old woman's face. For a minute, she was a small child lost in a carnival. Yes, she said after a bit. Yes, of course you're right. I'm sorry, Kanye. Lately, it seems my mind is. She didn't finish the thought, instead walking to the nightstand and gently taking the wreath of lunar tears from the drawer. The flower's petals had aged to a brilliant whiteness, and Kanye thought it was more beautiful now than the day she first received it. You're going to be a true woman soon, Grandma said as she placed the flowers in the girl's hair. So you mean less chatter about shades and building defensive walls, and more talk about how beautiful you've become. Annoyed, Kanye reached up to remove the garland, but the look on her grandmother's face stopped her hand. You're a beautiful thing, said her old woman, and there ain't another like you in all the world. I'm very proud of you. Okay, Grandma, that's enough compliments for one day. Such a mouth on you. Where did that come from? Gee, I wonder. I'll teach you sass, sassy girl, the grandma. Suddenly she lurched forward and grabbed Kanye by the ears, pulling her around the room with a crazed grin on her face. Grandma yelled Kanye in a quaking voice, Grandma, stop it. What the hell? The old woman stared at her and blinked and slowly held her wrinkled hand out as if it was the first time she'd ever seen them. Oh, I don't know what happened there. I'm sorry, girl. Sometimes my mind just. Kanye thought the look on her grandma's face was the most heartbreaking thing she'd ever seen. Listen, she began. Maybe you guys should stay home after all. Yeah, I won't have you stare keep an eye on the old codger like me. You go get your fruit and the wall and whatnot, I'll be fine. When you come back, I'll have a nice grasshopper dinner waiting for you. Kanye rolled her eyes and kissed her grandmother on the forehead and made ready to depart, trying desperately to ignore the worry that was gnawing on the walls for her. Kanye could feel the woman's eyes watching her as she moved down the path. Don't turn around, don't turn around, she told herself. The end of the temptation was too great. She spun on her heels and went by and looked and saw a small, bent woman standing in front of a ramshackle hut with a sad expression on her face. God, she looks so old now. It's like the wind could reach down and just carry her away. Kanye would wear the grandmother all day, causing her to work to suffer. What little fruit she could collect, she tossed carelessly into the wheelbarrow, and she only found a couple of stones before losing interest in the project. Finally, as dusk approached, she decided to call it a day. Cursing herself for lack of focus, Kanye pushed the nearly empty wheelbarrow back down the path. She crested the final hill, she suddenly froze in place. The wheelbarrow fell from her fingers and collapsed on its side, sending a few pieces of wrinkled brown fruit rolling back down the hill. Her gaze was transfixed by a thick black cloud that hovered just ahead. Tracing its path with a finger, Kanye suddenly felt her stomach knot in itself. Oh no! Her grandmother's house was ablaze, the flames licking up as if trying to reach touch the sky itself. Grandma! Grandma! Kanye ran then, faster than she'd ever moved in her life. When she tripped on the stone and went sprawling on the rocky ground, she leapt to her feet and continued running, unmindful of the blood that spilled from her wounded hands and knees. She got closer and closer, Kanye's mind began to race the time of her footfalls. Too dark, it's too dark. No, just fire. Can't be fire, too much smoke, gotta save for God's favor. She burst into the front yard and came to a seven hall, her worst suspicions confirmed, the smoke from the fire was mingling with the thick, inky blackness of an enormous shade. The massive creature supported itself on three twisted feet, which she balanced the remains of a large antlered tail. Scales, horns, and claws spread from its body in a random shadow pattern, giving it the appearance of a lizard designed by some insane god. Seeing Kanye let out the roar and flickered its tail, sending small whirlwinds spinning around the earth. For a moment, the creature appeared in shimmering iron inky blackness, as her mind was unable to comprehend that such a thing could actually exist, but then the smell hit her, a blend of rotted meat and excrement, and the horror became real once more. The creature bellowed again, and this time Kanye responded with a scream of her own. All right. She thought as she screamed, echoed off the high cliffs around her, it's you or me, let's go. The shape eyed Kanye with amused interest, and then again, looking from her to the house and back again, as if urgently to look at the destruction as her clothes gleefully rot. With dread filling her heart, Kanye glanced toward the house. Through the smoke and the flames, she saw a small figure struggling to escape her. Grandma! The sound of her voice alone began waving frantically. She's alive, thought Kanye, alive. Kanye's legs sprang to life, she raced across the yard toward the flaming wreckage of the house. Before she could advance more than a few steps, the shade opened its mouth and let out a roar of power from the uproot trees and sent them flying. The blast sent Kanye tumbling through the air before smashing against the rocky earth. Stars danced in front of her eyes, and she tried to remember how her legs worked. Get up, get up, get up! Kanye struggled up to her feet. The shade stomped down in the house and pinned her grandmother to the ground with the tip of a claw. The old woman struggled to move the claw from her stomach, but she might as well have been pushing a mountain. She coughed briefly, sending a small spray of blood into the air, then collapsed to the ground, her energy spent. Kanye lurched to her feet, only to fall back to the earth with a gasp. Ankles were on fire, one of both of them was surely broken. Ignoring the pain swimming through her body, she began dragging herself across the ground, leaving a drunken trail of dust and blood in her wake. Grandma, hold on just a little longer. The grandma's face was turning blue, her eyes turned back until only the white she exposed. Kanye pulled herself across the ground with maddening slowness, the distance seeming to increase with every second that passed. The shade glanced between the two women and flickered out its tongue, its giant mouth turning up that corner. Short panting breath reached from somewhere deep inside the core. Bastard, laughing at us. She had no idea that the mindless creature would experience emotion, but they had to know that the shade was taking joy in their suffering. Yeah, I see your plan. The shade moved his clock that way, but I'm not to do it again. He's clearly keeping her alive, only to step out of life when Kanye was close enough to touch her. I'm gonna kill you. From the other hand, Kanye raised her feet, but with a sickening snap from the right angle, the foot twisted backward and she forced it from her mind and began to hobble toward the monster. Pulling a small knife from the pouch of her waist, she leapt on the foot that pinned her grandma and plunged the weapon deep. Give her back, she screamed. Give her back to me. It was like stabbing a rock. With only a few swipes, the knife flowed from the hilt and the ball snapped. The shade panned. Panted laughter again, and raised its talons in it, rushing through the air toward the umbrella, and flashed by its foot. Kanye never had a chance. Self struck a square in the chest and sent her crashing into the burning wreckage of the home. As she lay on the ground with blood pouring from multiple wounds, a small weak voice spoke up. Kanye? Kanye's vision blurred, but she forced herself to focus on the sound. Finally, her eyes cleared enough for her to make out her grandmother's hand reaching out through the smoke. Grandma, Kanye, you gotta run. You can't best this one. Kanye grabbed the hand and on with all her strength. Grandma, come on, we have to go. The old woman coughed loudly. One of her hands, slick with blood, slipped from Kanye's grasp and thumped to the ground below. Grandma, no, no. I said, run. You have to live. You have to get through. The thought would stay forever unfinished. Before she could say another word, the shade's clawed foot descended, smashing the remains of the weapon down upon the shattered figure of the old woman. Blood oozed from gaps in the creature's toes as the terrible putrid smell assaulted Kanye's nose once again. She stared at the foot, dumbfounded. Convinced that what she was seeing could not possibly be real. When the creature fell into its appendage, all that remained underneath was a twisted, unrecognizable mass of rubble and red. Her grandmother was gone. Kanye blinked, trying to feel the hands which had been in hers the moment before. For a fleeting instant, she could remember the warmth of the embrace, the trembling of the fingers, but then the sensation drifted away in the breeze and was gone. Memories flashed through Kanye's mind one after another, faster and faster, until it became a meaningless jangle of noise. Kanye screamed in a thunderous sound that echoed off the cliff and seemed to roll away forever. Shade eased forward, black ichor pouring from its mouth and dissolving into smoke on the ground below. The earth shook with every step as it crept toward its prey. Kanye's body slowly rose, as if controlled by a mad puppet master. Her arms and legs were bent at impossible angles, her head lolled dangerously to the side, but somehow she managed to stand. Staring at the shade, her eyes began to glow with a deep red fire. The creature so confident just moments before took a slow, hesitant step backwards, trying to discern if this broken human could possibly pose a threat. Kanye seized the moment, laughing like a madman, as she looked into the air and plunged the shattered hilt of her knife deep in the leg of the shade. Shade shook Kanye off like a flash, and her crashing to the earth once again. Her chest rose and fell slowly, so the great weight were resting on it. Moist sounds of pain echoed through her mind. Something warm and thick oozed from her ears. Is that blood? Think it is. Think I'm bleeding to death. No, can't die. Grandma told me to live. Deep inside Kanye's mind, something finally broke. The sound of pain, the smoke, the flames, all that faded away until all that remained was a single incantation repeated over and over again. Kill it. As the spark that was Kanye's slipping into flicker and die, she felt her desire to kill and her desire to live blend into one. The distance between heartbeats grew longer and longer.
The beast approaches.
Oh, I know.
Must have. How did it even survive these past 5 years?
I'm not gonna let this happen again. It dies today. My sword fits lighter.
It's not the blade, but the skill of the user. Strike it down.
Oh, there's more. Gently, weakly, softly, the shade, sure that its tormentor is dead, turned and stomped off toward the horizon. Stopping along the way to bellow one final roar, couldn't kill it. Shame beyond imagining, Kanye tried to turn her head to the side, but only sitting coughing up a huge gout of blood. It was getting difficult to see, and only after a moment of fierce concentration did she realize that her left eye was gone. Laughing at herself, she turned her remaining eye to the ruins of her home and noticed a rugged stump of arm resting a few feet away. Yeah, that's mine, she thought with a mad giggle. This is going to be my clapping. Real bee. Hot, cried a sudden voice from the depths of her mind. Finally getting a diarrhea. Well, you had it coming. Go to hell, Demo, she thought with the unseen assailant. Go to hell before I pluck out your eyes and feed them to a dog. Voice of her childhood terror evaporated into smoke, only replaced by another, more recent voice. Hold still, said the apothecary, materializing from the ruins like a ghost. I want to draw you. That way you can live forever. No, stop. I don't want to live forever. I want to die right here. I see, said quietly. Well, if that's what you want. The spectral shopkeeper fluttered in and out of existence for a moment, then produced a piece of paper and sketched quickly. After a few seconds, he turned the page and Kanye and smiled. Since you rejected my offer, I decided to draw someone else. Picture of the grandmother, real as life. Kanye opened her mouth and think a man. But stopped as the picture began to blacken in the middle. Before she could see anything, dozens of multi-legged insects began to swarm across the image, tearing at it with sharpened pincers. Stop, no, don't hurt that picture. Kanye reached out with her remaining arm and waved fear futilely in the air. To her surprise, the insects fell off the picture in the ground below, where they vanished into black tendrils of smoke. Relieved, Kanye turned her good eye back to the picture, only to open her mouth in a silent scream. Sketching a shirt of grandmother as she truly was, a smash in her face of a lump of nothing. The apothecary smiled and broke into a jolly dance. See that? He cried as he danced his jig. It's perfect now. She looks just like you. Ha, cha 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 cha. I look like that. Oh god, I'm gonna die. Drowning in despair, Kanye laid her head back in the mud and smoke of her ruined house and waited for the end to come. But just as she let go of everything, an unfamiliar voice began whispering in her ear. Ain't you got a wish, sunshine? voice is vulgar and fierce at the same time, as if insanity had somehow found a way to take form. Kanye wanted to scream at the voice, crawled under her skin, but her lungs refused to work. You know, a wish, like a prayer or something. Why don't you get on your knees and start praying to heaven? Please, invisible man in the sky, save me, save me. Kanye finally resorted to shouting at the voice with her mind. I don't make wishes, they don't come true for me. I'm a curse, a freak. I should be left to die. The other voice boomed in her ears. Oh God, you are the best. Kanye glanced down and saw a black shining substance oozing from her legs. She tried to brush it away, but her remaining arm had no longer responded. The substance slowly crept around her feet and began moving up toward the rest of her body. Is this death? Is this what it looks like? Is the mind just losing itself? She could feel the same oozing upward, feel this hot, searing pain it left in its wake. Whatever else might be happening, she was still alive. And this was real. Come on, said the voice. Let it go. Kanye tried to ignore the voice and concentrate on the pain, but the newcomer would have none of it. Don't ignore me, sunshine. You ready to give up? Ready to die? So why not let me have it? Have what? Your body. Come on, give it to me. Give it to me. I want to stand on the ground, feel the rain, taste the wind. The voice paused as if licking its lips. When it resumed, it was filled with mad, unabated joy. I want to take your hands and use them to choke the goddamn life out of people. I want to tear out your throats and bathe in the blood just like before. In response, Kanye shifted her head and vomited. The warmth of it crept down her front and mingled with the pain of the encroaching black ooze. Are you ashamed? Yeah, maybe. What of it? Slime reached her face, crept up past her nose, and slowly oozed into the socket of her missing eye. The moment it touched her brain, Kanye was struck by the most powerful sensation she'd ever felt alive. It was ecstasy. She wanted to scream with delight, but all she could manage was a small whispered moan. Feels good, don't it? Asked the voice with a chuckle. Yeah, what can I say? I know how to please the ladies. Now give me the body. Come on, give me the body, and I'll give you more than this feeling. It's a fair trade. Black lump began to protrude from Kanye's side. As she watched, it grew longer and thicker, eventually taking the form of her missing arm. I can see better, she thought. My eyes must be growing back, too. Slime reached up to envelop the rest of her face, but she managed to brush it away. Stop, she whispered, marveling at how she regained her voice. Stop. Black Ooze hesitated. It was considered this request, and quickly swimming down her body before disappearing into a cloud of smoke. Ah, what the heck, sunshine, screamed the voice. We had a deal. I thought you wanted to die. Grandma said, I can't die. Brief image of her grandma. Her mother bloodied and broken, flashed before her eyes. She saw the shade that had killed her and heard its mocking laughter, then closed her eyes and forced the image from her mind. Her whole body was quaking with rage. When she opened her eye again, they brushed bright, burned bright red. That thing took my grandmother. I have to kill it before I die. Kanye glanced down and saw the mysterious pattern. The pattern of the shades burned itself into her left arm. Well, I'll be damned, said the voice cheerfully. Look at that, sunshine. I think that you and me are going to be good friends now. Kanye stared intently at her arm. The more emotional she felt, the more letters seemed to be ready to puncture her skin and begin to release the rest of her body. The arm clearly had a will of its own now. Stop. Gotta stop. Holding her left arm in the right, Kanye took a deep breath and tried to calm herself. Come on, don't fight it, panted the voice. Here's my favorite dish, and I'm hungry. Let it go. Feel the anger, burn the fire of revenge, thirst for blood, and then go out there and shut up. Shut up and get the heck out of my body. Your body, oh, that's rich, sunshine, real rich. Look, why don't you just up and die so I can have this body for myself? What do you say? I bet those buddies who are in the area would love to see you dead. Kanye grabbed a nearby shard of glass and tried to saw off the shade-infected portion of her side. Before she could, a darkened left arm grabbed her right wrist, crushing it. Kanye screamed and dropped the shard, and the sound of bone crunching and bone filled the air. Quahaha, stupid idiot girl, you're possessed now. Sunshine, no going back. The voice laughed again, a loud, long wail that seemed to go on with it. Possessed, whispered Kanye. Yeah, possessed. You and me, we might call a timeshare arrangement. Remember how folks used to think that you were a freak? Well, what do they get a load of you now? Kanye looked, tears in her eyes, this guy seems smaller, somehow darker. Is this because of that shade? Is this how you see the world? So, listen, purred the voice. I know this whole possession thing seems a bit sudden, but it ain't so bad. There's plenty of it for you, too. I'm a very powerful creature, sunshine, and now the power belongs to you. You got enemies, people you want to kill, I can make it happen. The little fat kid who kept picking on you, the big old shade that squashed your brain. Or wrap them up in their own buttholes. No more abuse for you, sunshine, no more pain. Wait. Kanye, you're a shade. Why would you help me kill another shade? What do you think? I'm some kind of racist? Killing sound? I'll give a good GB who you murder, honey pants. I just want to drink from the well. Kanye considered this. She struggled to her feet and the power of the shade coursing through her. The smoke from her house was drifting away in the wind, and she enjoyed the way the cool evening breeze felt in her new left arm. After a long pause, the voice spoke up again. So how about it, you and me? We could get some good times together. Look, I'll even take care of the bloody part if you don't want. F off, a-hole, muttered Kanye. I'll handle the killing. Quahaha, screamed the voice. Look at you go. Oh, sunshine, we're going to have so much fun. So listen, my name's T-Ran, and if you ever need me, I'll just be hanging out on a piece of meat called your heart. Now get to it. The more you kill, the more heart turns rotten and sour, and I like rotten and sour. And you found yourself nodding at the voice. Yeah, she said. Yeah, I think this can work. I'm going to find that Shay. I'm going to strangle it with its own gut. And when I'm done, I'm going to do the same to you, Tyrone. Count on it. Ooh, laughed Tyrone. Oh, that's bigger than you. And I looked at that. Oh, and hey, one more thing. Right now, you and me got to share in the spot. If you ever run out of hate, if you ever, you know, go soft, then I'm going to take over everything. So keep on killing, Sunshine, and watch your back. Voice grew fainter and gradually faded away, fading to somewhere deep inside Tanya herself. Tanya waited until she was sure the voice was gone, then waved her new left arm around a few times. That was perfectly normal, she thought. This is mine. Desperately, she began poking and prodding at the alien, trying to find something wrong with it. She didn't want it to feel normal. That would mean the creature inside her had already won. I'm not a shade, I'm Tanya. Repeating this mantra in her mind, she slowly began digging through the rubble of her house, being careful to ignore a certain red stained spot in the corner. Finally, after what seemed like an attorney of heartbreaking work, she found what she was looking for. It was a wreath of blooming tears. Though it had been through hell and back, the garland's petals were bright as ever. Tanya started to place it in her hair, then slowly turned the wreath and stared at it. I'm sorry, Grandma, I'm so sorry. I don't deserve to wear this anymore. I'm possessed, corrupted, a freak. And this time I don't think there's any going back. Holding the flowers to her heart, Tanya fell to the ground and sobbed. As night gradually lingered to dawn, people of Area arose to daily life. She remained in that position as if tears to my watch away the horror that infected the world.
Alive!
Oh my goodness gracious.
Stay alive! Stay alive!
Grandma.
Kaine, you gotta live! You gotta come back to us!
With Yona?
We are still no closer to finding her. We need a way to locate the Shadow Lord.
By the way, this is for you.
Is that a lunar tear?
It's not as good as your grandmother's, but I tried.
No, it's great. Thank you.
Kaine waking from her long, petrified sleep. Neil's unflagging kindness. Our reunion was a happy one. And we let it wash over us like rain. That is, until Devila and Popola had to go and ruin it all.
Are you kidding me? You can't be serious!
Please, try to understand. People are tired and scared, and... I'm sorry. I'm sorry you have to bear the brunt of that.
That's pretty important, you know that?
This is crap, and you know it!
Oh, we should do that first.
It's okay. We can sleep outside.
No one's sleeping outside. You and Kaine saved this village, and now...
People are afraid of us. And really, I understand. I mean, look at me. As long as you're still with us, I can deal with it. Right, Kaine?
I'm used to sleeping outside.
But...
We'll see you later.
Sorry about this.
What is the matter?
Kaine always sleeps outside. I never thought about that until just now. Never even occurred to me. Damn it.
We should turn in.
I didn't get much sleep that night. For the first time in my life, I hated Devila. For the first time in my life, I doubted Popola. But those feelings are pointless in the end. They said and did what they did for the sake of the village. To protect it from the horror of the Shades. Really, how can I blame Devila and Popola? In the end, I'm just as bad. Because I never once stopped to think about Kaine and Emile's situation myself. Apologize to Kaine and Emile. But what good would that even do?
I got a fire going, Kaine.
Wait, is that...
Campfires are weird, aren't they?
I'm so happy to get to talk to you again, Kaine.
Yeah, me too.
I tried everything I could think of to save you, you know. I polished you with a special cloth. I poured warm water over you.
Wait, you poured water on me?
Yeah, but it didn't really do much except make you all shiny.
Hey, Emile. Thanks for saving me.
I guess you noticed how I look different now.
I'm sorry, Emile. I'm sorry for all of it.
Well, I mean, this new form isn't all bad, you know? At least I can look at you when we talk, right? Hey, so why don't you tell me something about yourself?
I'm not very interesting, sorry.
Come on, I just want to know you better. Please?
Fine. This all happened when I was a kid. Before the whole shade possession thing. My body is different. And when the villagers found out about it, they started treating me like a freak. But one person, my grandmother, accepted me just as I was. No matter how bad things got, she gave me the strength to keep going.
She's really special to you, huh?
Yeah.
Oh, hey! That gives me an idea. Since we cured your petrification, we should start looking for a way to cure your possession and my body. I know we can do it if we all work together. Heck, it'll probably be super easy.
Let me guess. More warm water?
Okay. Can we just forget I told you about that?
It is creepy just listening to guys talk.
Sleep well?
Sure.
And yet your red eyes tell a different tale. Don't be so hard on yourself, lad.
I need to go see Devila and Popola.
Very well. What might that be?
It's Mom's diary.
I have not heard you speak much about...
She got the black scrawl and died when I was little.
My apologies for bringing it up.
It's all right. I can barely remember her face anymore. This is the only thing I have left of her. Reading it helps remind me of when we were still a family.
I see.
But the final entries get a little strange.
In what way?
Well, here. Take a look.
Say there. Can you not hear me? Why are you standing about like a slack-jawed ninny?
Sorry. Felt like I was dreaming or something.
Oh, sleeping on one's feet is quite the talent indeed. Come now. There's the door.
Right. Let's go.
At this point, you'll end up with a save until the battle is over. Do you want to... Let's do it. The world of recycled vessel created to avoid destruction of all. Believe the thought coins are quite dark. They are legion. They go into the world of the darkness.
Thank you. indemnification agreement. Okay, so. Alright, so I think the indemnification agreement is the one.
My word. Something wrong?
I feel as if I've just awoken from a most unpleasant dream.
I know what you mean. That happened.
Hi. I kind of thought you'd never talk to us again.
I understand you're doing this for the village, and that you don't have a choice.
Pretty much, yeah. But look, why don't you go talk to Popola? I think she wanted to discuss the Shadow Lord with you.
Yeah. I'm headed there next. Oh, and Devila?
Yeah?
Sorry about yesterday. I shouldn't have lost my temper like that.
You don't need to apologize. Anyone would be upset when their friends are hurting. Let Emil and Kaine know that we're sorry, all right?
All right.
What is the purpose of this place?
Beats me. Maybe it's Popola's hobby corner. Popola?
Oh, hello.
Look, I want to apologize for yes.
Stop. You didn't do anything wrong.
Yeah. But neither did you. You're just trying to protect the villagers. And I'd jump down your throat for it.
It's very kind of you to say so. Regardless, please don't let it trouble you.
Ahem. I believe there was something you wished to discuss with us.
Oh, right. Yes, about that. You know about the lost shrine, right?
The temple where I was first discovered.
That's it. Well, it seems that the Shadow Lord's lair is connected to it somehow.
Oh ho. It was right under our pages the whole time.
But the bridge that leads there is unusable.
So take a boat.
A boat?
Yes. The canal's finally been repaired. It took a lot longer than expected, what with the shades and all. I also asked them to provide a boat at the path to the Lost Shrine's back entrance. The ferryman will let you use it free of charge. That should make it easier for you to move from town to town.
Thanks, Popola. I feel like you've done so much for me. I'm really grateful. All right, I'll see you around.
And for the love of everything, be careful.
Path above the entrance to the shopping district should lead to the boat landing.
How excellent to know the canal is finished. Hopefully this puts our days of running all over behind us.
The faster we can move, the faster we can save Yona. Let's use it as often as we need.
Job should I give you first? The tavern keeper in Seafront needs your help. I think he's looking for food again. I wrote down the client's location on your map, so head over there to get the details.
The slovenly half of that couple who refused to stop arguing.
Hey, it's been a while.
Sure has. I've been in charge of this canal since we last talked. Apparently I did a pretty good job with it because they decided to make me the permanent ferryman.
Oh yeah, huh? Congrats.
Thanks. Still, it's not all puppies and unicorns. The old ball and chain is always harping on me now about how much I work. Anyway, if you got a place to be, just let me know and I'll take you there.
Hey, remember that book you found for me? Well, there's another recipe that piqued my interest. Would you mind helping me out again?
What are you making now?
Broiled catfish served over rice. I just need 10 giant catfish and 10 bags of rice. Think you can help me out?
Vice, are there any recipes written inside you?
How dare you compare me to a common cookbook? There is no room within my pages for such trivial matters.
I haven't seen my old drinking buddy lately.
You need material? If you need every fish we...
Hi there. Come back if you...
Oh, okay, that's what this is good.
Thank you.
between this cluster and the community.
Have your ingredients.
Right then, here's your payment. And now let me whip this up. La-da-da. All right, dig in. How is it?
It's delicious. I just wish I could share it with Yona.
Woo! We've got another item for the menu.
I'll definitely try to stop by again. Good luck.
Please,
Which job should I... I wrote...
Thank you. I'm done believing in people.
My wife's been acting kind of strange.
What should I do?
Don't talk to me!
Thank you.
They appear to be out at the moment.
Oh my god. Striking bad.
The Lost Shrine's up ahead, just past,
as well as the Shadow Lord's castle.
Let us make haste.
Oh, there!
Have a good night.